Good afternoon, friends. Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to Uncle Sam's Korean lesson and Korean language class in Facebook page and also YouTube. So let us start our lesson today. Today is November 25, Thursday. It is 5 o'clock in the Philippines, 6 o'clock in Korea, and 2:30 in India. Okay, so first of all, let us try to see some interest area. Can we say 관심?
관심.
Yeah, 관심 is a Sino-Korean word, which is 한자. That came from Chinese letters and which became Korean word for many hundred years. 관심 means interest. So, what is your interest? Okay, can you say 분야?
분야.
Okay, 분야 is an area. So, what is your interest area? What is your 관심 분야? Can you say 관심 분야가 뭐예요?
관심 분야가 뭐예요?
Yeah, what is your interest area? Okay, you, 관심 is interest, 분야 is area. We use the word 가 to make it a subject. Subject, 가 is the subject particle. Can we say 뭐?
뭐?
Okay, 뭐 is what? Another word for 무엇? Can we say 예요?
예요.
Okay, if you use 예요, that means is it? So you can make a question. And if you want to answer, you just put the ending down, 예요. If you want to ask question, 예요. Okay, 뭐예요?
뭐예요?
What is it? Okay. Okay, 관심 분야가 뭐예요?
관심 분야가 뭐예요?
Okay, what is your interest? Okay, what is your interest? 취미가 뭐예요?
취미가 뭐예요?
취미 is a hobby. For example, some of you are working in the office. Some of you are students. So, working in the office, you are 사무원. Okay, office worker. You are student, 학생. Some of you are doctor. So, 의사. Now, those are your 직업. 직업 is a job, occupation, profession. Now, 취미 is hobby. So, we can talk about it. And 관심 분야, which is interest area. Now, let us see the second slide. Can we say 뭐예요?
뭐예요?
Okay, you can use the noun, after noun, put the word e. E is the subject particle. So if you put e or ga, use e after consonant ending, use ga after vowel ending. So if you use e or ga, that becomes a subject in a sentence. By putting E and ga after noun. Okay, 뭐예요 is what is it? Okay, 이름이 뭐예요?
이름이 뭐예요?
What is your name? Can we say 이름?
이름.
Okay, 이름 means name. Okay, 직업이 뭐예요?
직업이 뭐예요?
Okay, 직업 is profession. Occupation or your work. Okay, what is your work? 직업이 뭐예요? Can we say 학생이에요?
학생이에요.
Okay, I'm a student. 선생님이에요?
선생님이에요.
Okay, I'm a teacher. However, it's like if you say 선생님, it's like you are lifting up yourself because 님 is already respectful. So the common word for teacher is 교사. Can you say 교사?
교사.
Okay, 교사 means teacher. So 교사예요.
교사예요.
Okay, 교사 is the same as 선생, but we put the word 님 just to show respect. However, can we put name after student? Usually we do not, although we could. Okay, 학생이에요. Okay, what is your work? 의사예요?
의사예요.
Okay.
의사예요.
I'm a doctor. Okay. What is your work? 사무원이에요?
사무원이에요.
Okay. I'm an office worker. Okay. What is your work? 경찰이에요?
경찰이에요.
Okay. I'm a policeman. 경찰관 is policeman. 경찰 is police. Okay. What is your work? 소방관이에요?
소방관이에요.
Okay. Fireman. 소방관. Okay. Now, can we say 국적?
국적.
Okay. 국적 is your nationality or citizenship. If you go abroad and then you're going to write something, you know, in the paper, they may ask you what is your nationality and what is your citizenship. And we know that nationality and citizenship may seem the same, however, they have their particularity. So some people have dual citizenship. You know, for some countries allow dual citizenship. Anyway, in Korea, things are changing today. But before, we did not have so many foreigners in our country. Today we have 2 million foreigners in Korea, but before we did not have so many foreigners. So we considered nationality and citizenship the same. So we only have one word for 국적, that is nationality and citizenship. However, we have another one, 시민권, that is citizenship, but we don't use it so much. So. 현재 국적이 뭐예요?
국적이 뭐예요?
Okay, what is your nationality? Okay, can you say 몇 살이에요?
몇 살이에요?
How old are you? Can you say 몇?
몇?
Okay, 몇 means how much? Okay, how many? 살?
살?
Age, okay. 몇 살?
몇 살?
How old? Okay. 몇 살이에요?
몇 살이에요?
How old are you? 한 살이에요.
한 살이에요.
Okay, I am 1 year old. However, I think a 1 year old child cannot answer that he or she is 1 year old already. My second granddaughter is 1 year old, but she cannot answer, "Grandpa, I am 1 year old." She just smile or say, "Ba ba 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 ba." Okay, so can you say, "한 살이에요?"
한 살이에요.
Yeah, 1 year old. 열 살이에요.
열 살이에요.
10 years old. 스무 살이에요.
20살이에요.
네, 20 years old. 30살이에요.
30살이에요.
30 years old. However, in some countries, it is not proper to ask your age, especially if you are a lady. So you could say, 왜요? Okay, why are you asking me my age? Okay, and you could also answer 몰라요.
몰라요.
Okay, I don't know my age. But you can also say 잘 몰라요.
잘 몰라요.
Okay, 잘 means well, so 몰라요 is I don't know, so I don't know much. Okay, so what do you mean if you don't know so much about age? Do you mean to say you know little? Anyway, can you say 알아요?
알아요.
알아요 means I know. Okay, can you say 조금?
조금.
조금 means little, so it could be a bit. 조금 알아요.
조금 알아요.
Okay, can you say 그 사람 알아요?
그 사람 알아요.
사람 is a person. 그 is that, so 그 사람 is that person. So 그 사람 알아요 means do you know that person? And you answer 네, 조금 알아요.
네, 조금 알아요.
조금 알아요. Yes, I know him a bit. 네, 많이 알아요.
네, 많이 알아요.
Okay, 알아요. I know him well. 아, 알겠어요.
알겠어요.
Okay, 알겠어요 means what is 알겠어요 means I got it. I understood it. Okay. So 알겠습니다.
알겠습니다.
Okay, 알겠습니다 means I got it in a formal way. I should say formal, not informal. Okay, so let us continue. 나이가 몇 살이에요?
나이가 몇 살이에요?
Okay, 나이 means age. Okay, so if you say 나이가 몇 살이에요? How old is your age? Okay, so which means how old are you? Okay, can we say one more time? 나이가 몇 살이에요?
나이가 몇 살이에요?
Okay. Then and then we can ask 왜요?
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 Okay. 왜요 means why? Why are you asking me my age? 궁금해서요.
궁금해서요.
Okay. I am curious. Okay. 궁금하다.
궁금하다.
To be curious. Okay. 궁금해요.
궁금해요.
I am curious. 궁금해서요.
궁금해서요.
Because I am curious. Okay. 하나.
하나
is one. 둘.
둘.
셋.
셋.
Okay. 셋 is three. 넷.
넷.
다섯. 다섯 is five. 여섯.
여섯.
일곱.
일곱.
여덟.
여덟.
여덟 is 여덟 is eight. 오케이. 아홉.
아홉.
오케이. 열.
열.
오케이. This is how we count our. Our number in Korean 1 to 10, but when we say that in the age, we have to say 한 살,
한 살,
한 살,
두 살,
두 살,
세 살,
세 살,
네 살,
네 살.
Okay, take a note of this 하나 둘 셋 넷. 1, 2, 3, 4 changes to 한, 두, 세, 네. Okay, 하나 becomes 한. Then you say 하나, 한.
하나, 한.
Okay, 하나 is 1. 한 is when you say the age, 1 year. 둘, 두.
둘, 두.
둘 is 2. 두 is 2 as in adjective. 셋, 세.
셋, 세.
Okay, 셋 is number 3. 세 is ordinal number. So 하나 둘 셋 넷 is cardinal number, which is 1 2 3 4. Okay, 한 두 세 네 is adjective. Say 1 year 2 year 3 year. Okay, 넷 네.
넷 네.
Okay, 넷 is 4. 네 is 4 as in adjective. Okay, 한 살 두 살 세 살 네 살.
한 살, 두 살, 네 살?
No, no, 세 살, 네 살. Okay, one more time.
세 살, 네 살, 세 살, 네 살.
Okay, one more time. 한 살, 두 살.
한 살.
두 살.
한 살, 두 살.
세 살.
세 살.
네 살.
네 살.
Okay, 1 year old, 2 years old, 3 years old, 4 years old. But if you say 1, 2, 3, 4, 하나, 둘, 셋, 넷.
하나 둘 셋 넷.
Okay, 하나 둘 셋 넷 changes to 한 두 세 넷.
한 두 세 넷.
Okay, 하나 한 살 둘 두 살.
하나 한 살 한 살
Set, 세 살.
Net,
네 살.
Net, 네 살.
Okay, so from 1 to 4, if you say the age, 하나, 둘, 셋, 넷 changes to another form. 한, 두, 세, 넷. So do not say 하나 살, you have to say 한 살. Do not say 둘 살, you have to say 두 살. Do not say 셋 살, you have to say 세 살. Do not say 넷 살, you have to say 네 살. So one more time, 한, 두, 세, 네.
한, 두, 세, 네.
Okay, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years old. However, from number 5 until 10, it is the same, okay? So cardinal number and the number for saying the age is the same. So 다섯 살.
다섯 살.
여섯 살.
여섯 살.
일곱 살.
일곱 살.
여덟 살.
여덟 살.
아홉 살.
아홉 살.
열 살.
열 살.
Okay, so from number 5 until number 10, just put the word 살. However, because it is ending in consonant, 살 will change to 쌀. Can you say 쌀?
쌀.
Okay, 쌀 is rice. 쌀 is the age, but 쌀 will pronounce as 쌀, 쌍시옷 or 더블시옷 because of the consonant ending in the previous word. Okay, however, 한 살 is still 살. 두 살, 한 살, 두 살, 세 살, 네 살. Look at that. It has no consonant at the bottom, isn't it? 한, 두, 세, 네 has no consonant at the bottom. So we retain 살. Okay? But 다섯, 여섯, 일곱, 여덟, 아홉, 열 has consonant at the bottom. So 살 becomes 살. So do you get it? Okay, so, let us say 1, 2, 3, 4 with 살. 한 살, 두 살, 세 살, 네 살.
한 살, 두 살, 세 살, 네 살.
Okay, so 1 year until 4 years old, 살 becomes still 살. But 5 years until 10 years old, 살 changes to 살. Okay, 다섯 살, 여섯 살, 일곱 살, 여덟 살, 아홉 살, 열 살.
5살, 6살, 7살, 8살, 9살.
Okay, so take notice that if you do not have the consonant at the bottom, sal remains still the same sound. But if you have the consonant at the bottom, sal changes to sal, the hard sangsiot, hard siot, which is double siot or sangsiot. This rule applies to almost all Korean words. If you have a consonant at the bottom, the following consonant at the top will change to a hard sound. Okay. Now let us learn by tens. We studied 1 to 10. Now let us learn by the unit of tens. 열.
열
is 10. 스물. Okay, 스물 is 20. 서른. 서른 is 30. 마흔. 마흔 is 40. 쉰.
쉰
is 50. 예순. 60. 일흔. 일흔 is 70. 여든. 여든 is 80. 아흔. 아흔 is 90. How about 100? 백. 100. Okay, take a notice here. From 열 until 백, this is what we say. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. However, the one we have to notice is 20. Okay, 20 is 스물, but if you will use 20 as adjective, it changes to 스무. Can you say 스무?
스무.
Okay, so we do not say 스물살 about 20 years old. We have to say 스무살. Can you say 스무살?
스무살.
Okay, because 스무, mu is ending in vowel. The word 살 will still become 살. It will retain the sound. But look at the word 열, 서른, 마흔, 쉰, 예순, 일은, 여든, 아흔, 백. Everything has a consonant at the bottom. So 살 will become 쌀. Do you get it? Okay, 열 쌀.
열
쌀. Okay, 10 years old. 스무 쌀.
스무
쌀. Okay, because 스무 is ending in vowel. 쌀 is not 쌀, but 쌀. 서른 쌀. Okay, look at that. When it is 니은 at the bottom, 살 still becomes 살, 서른 살, 마흔 살. Okay, when the bottom is 니은, still 살 will become 살, 쉰 살, 예순 살.
예순
살,
일흔 살,
여든 살,
여든 살,
아흔 살,
아흔 살.
Okay, from 스무, which is 20, until 아흔, which is 90, we see that there is 니은 at the bottom. When there is 니은 at the bottom, the following word will still remain the sound. So 살 becomes 살, but 열, which is 10, has 리을 at the bottom, and 백, which is 100, has 기억 at the bottom, and 살 will change to 살. Okay, let's put in our mind, if there is no consonant, 살 will become still 살. If the consonant at the bottom is 니은, 살 will still become 살. All other consonant, 살 will change to 살. Okay? Can we say 한 살? Okay, 한 살 is 한 year old. Okay, 백 살?
백 살.
Okay, the 한 is ending in 니은, so 살 becomes still 살, 한 살. 백 is ending in 기억, so 살 changes to 살, 백 살. Now look at this one. After tens, 열, 스물 until 백. For example, you may be not only 10 years old, you may be not only 20 or 30 years old, but you could be 11 or 12 or 13. So there could be 10 and another word like 15. So what do we do? After using this, 열, 스물, 서른, 마흔, 쉰, just put the cardinal number, okay? Let's say, we have to maintain the one up there, 한 until 열. Can you say 열 한 살?
열 한 살.
Okay, 열 is 10, 한 is 1, as in adjective, so 열 한 살 is 11. But the Korean number for 11 is 열하나, isn't it? Can you say 열하나?
열하나.
Okay, 열하나 is number 11, but if you will use it for the age, it has to be an adjective. So 열한살.
열한살.
Okay, what is number 12 in Korean? 열둘?
열열살.
열, yes.
열살.
Number... Yes, number 12 is 열둘, number 12 is 열둘, but you cannot say 열둘 살, you have to say 열두 살, okay? What is number 13?
열두 살.
Yes, what is number 13 in Korean?
Okay.
열세.
열세.
But if you will use it for the age, 열세 살.
열세 살.
Okay. What is number 14?
열네.
열네 is 14.
열네.
Okay, how do you say 14 years old? 열네 살.
열네.
Okay, so 11 to 14, that is how you do. 열한, 열두, 열세, 열네. Instead of saying 열하나, 열둘, 열셋, 열네, you have to maintain this one. However, from 15 to 20, it's all the same, okay? So, 15살, what is 15살?
15.
About 16 years old?
16.
Okay, anyone of you 16? Oh, no, no one. Okay, how about 17? 17 years old? 17살. Okay, 18살. 19살. 20살. Okay, anyone is 20, 21 among you? 21?
네.
Oh, how do you say I am 21 years old? 21살. 21살. Can you say 21살? Okay, look at the one. If you say you are 20, 20 is 스물, but adjective becomes 스무. However, 21 is different. 21 is not 21살, it is 21살. Okay? Okay, how about 22? 22살. Okay, how about 23? Anyone 23? Okay, 23살. How about 24? 24살. 25? Anybody 25? How do you say 25? Thirty 살입니다. Okay, the same. 31살, 32살. Okay. Okay, let's say together. 10살.
10살.
10 years old.
10살.
20살.
20살.
Okay, 20살, 20 years old. But if you say 21, 22, 23, you have to say 스물. 21살 instead of 스무. 30살. Yes. Yes.
How about 35?
35?
30 plus 5.
Okay, 35살.
35살.
Okay, 35살. Are you 35? Okay. Okay, 35살.
네, 네.
35살. 엄마예요? 엄마? Are you a mother?
Yes.
엄마예요. 엄마예요. 자녀가 몇 명 있어요? 자녀 is children. How many children do you have?
One little daughter. 3 years old.
세 살짜리.
세 살.
Okay, you can say 짜리, 세 살짜리, 짜리, 딸. Can you say 딸? 딸이 있어요.
딸.
I have daughter. 딸이 있어요. 세 살이에요.
딸이. Okay.
저는 35살이에요. Okay. Yeah. Can we say 마흔? Okay. Anybody more than 40? Okay. 40 to 50. Okay. Can you say 신? Okay. 50. I am 54. 54살. 54살이에요. We can also say 시은. Okay, so 예순 is 60, 일은 is 70, 여든 is 80, 아흔 is 90. So you put just after that, 한 살, 두 살, 세 살, 네 살. So 91, 92. Anybody 100 years old among you? Okay, none. Okay. So 저는 100살이에요. Okay, 100. You know, there was a news yesterday. Somebody died in the Philippines, and she is 120 something. And then I heard in the newspaper they are requesting her to be recognized as the oldest person who died with the oldest age. Okay, but I'm not very sure about that. So I wish that we will live all long life. Okay, in the Philippines, we call it mabuhay. Mabuhay means long life. In Korea, we say manse, manse. In English, long live. Okay, so but not just living long life. I pray that you will live healthy life. Healthy life. And happy life. What if we live long but not happy, isn't it? Okay, so next one, we're going to have checklist. Okay, checklist for our bio data or resume. It is called 이력서. If you are going to apply in a company, they will require your bio data. Okay, first, can you say 이름?
이름.
Yes, 이름. You will see in a paper, it is written there, 이름. Sometimes they write it 성명. Can you say 성명?
성명.
Okay, 이름 is a native Korean word for name. 성명 is the Sino-Korean word. Sometimes they use 이름. Sometimes they use 성명. So that means name. So 이름이 뭐예요?
이름이 뭐예요?
Okay, what is your name? But in the paper, we have to write. We cannot answer with verbally. In a paper, we have to write our name. Okay, in Korea, we put the family name first. Can you say Song?
Song.
Okay, Song is family name. So we put the surname first. After family name, we put our given name. Okay, I think in other countries, you put the given name first, isn't it? And family name comes later. In Korea, family name comes first. For example, if your name is James Kim, you have to put Kim James, okay? Can you say 나이?
나이.
Okay, 나이 is the age. Now, Korean way of counting age is different. From the Western age. Okay, so for example, in the Western culture, you are 1 year old after 1 year of the time you are born. So for example, if you are born on May 5, 1964, you are 1 year old in the following year, May 5, 1965. But in Korea, you are already 1 year old by the time you are born. Okay, we have a different way of counting. And then we have another age during the new year. So we don't have another age during our birthday, but we have a new another age when the new year comes, January 1. So for example, if you are born on December 31, you are still 1 day old. The following day, you will be 2 days old. However, in Korean way of counting age, if you are born on December 31, the following day, which is January 1, you are supposed to be 2 days old in the Western culture, in the West. But in Korea, you are already 2 years old. You get that? Do you understand what I'm saying? So in the
if
29 December, you will be two years old after December 30, 31, January 1. When you become 4 days old, which is January 1, you are 2 years old. So it's not the so in Korea.
27 years old.
Yeah, so you are 35 in English, right? In the West, 35. So if you are 35, but your birthday is finished or not? Your birthday. Your birthday is December 29. So you don't have your birthday is still coming. So if you are 35, in Korean age, you are let's say you are 37. Okay, you are 37 in Korea. Now, if your birthday is already Finnish, you are 36. Because, as I mentioned, in the West, you become 1 year older during your birthday. So if your birthday is Finnish, the gap between Korean age and the Western age is 1 year old. But if your birthday is not Finnish, the gap is 2 years old. Okay. How about you, Rianka? Is your birthday finished?
No, yes,
Your birthday is finished. Okay, so if your birthday is done already, and if you are 25, in Korean age, you are 26. Okay? Okay, so the way how we put in our resume in Korea is, they will use the one, can you say man?
Man.
Okay, if the paper says man, that means English age, okay? So exact age following the Western culture. So when we are talking to people, so they say 몇 살이에요? 나이가 몇 살이에요? We give our Korean age, but in a resume, mostly we follow the Western way too. Okay, okay. So that's how it is. Can we say 성별?
성별.
Okay, 성별 is sex, which means are you a male or female? Okay, let us learn some important one. Can you say 남성?
남성.
Okay, 남성 is male. Can you say 남자?
남자.
Okay, 남자 is man. So what is the difference? In your resume, if you are a man, you are not going to put 남자. You will just put the one 남, which means male, okay, which means 남성. How about female, 여성?
여성.
Okay, 여성 is 여성 is female. 여자?
여자.
Okay, 여자 is woman. So in the resume, we will just put 여 or 녀, which means a woman. But we don't say 여자. 여자 is colloquial when we talk in a conversation. Now, next one is 국적.
국적.
Okay, 국적 is nationality or your citizenship. When Korea was not a multicultural society, we don't have this item in our resume because during those days, everyone is Korean. So every person inside Korea is a Korean, Korean citizen, Korean national. So we seldom had foreigners, but today, because of the free travel and because of many changes, there are so many foreigners living in Korea, according to statistics, more than 2 million foreigners. So Korea is no longer one culture society today. Although majority of people are Koreans, we still have a good number of foreigners. So number one foreigners in Korea is Chinese, ethnic Chinese, and Vietnamese, Filipinos, and so many people from Asia and also Western country. So in some companies today, they have this item, 국적. What is 국적?
Nationality.
Okay, so you have to put your nationality, and we will go to that in a while. Next one is 주소.
주소.
Okay, 주소 is the address. So about 주소, we have the permanent address, which is 본적, and then we have a present address. So they distinguish that. Okay, now about 주소, can we say 어디 살아요? Okay, where do you live? Okay, 주소 is address. Can you say 어디?
어디?
Okay, 어디 is where. 살아요?
살아요.
살아요 means do you live? Okay, or reside. It is a residence. 어디 살아요?
어디 살아요?
Okay, where do you live? 한국에 살아요. Okay, if you put the word 에 after 한국, which is Korea, it becomes in, okay? I live in Korea. 인도에 살아요.
인도에 살아요.
Okay, I live in India. Yes. 필리핀에 살아요. Okay, live in the Philippines. It comes from the word 살다. 살다 means to live. That's the basic word for living. So to live is 살다. 살아요. 살아요 is do you live? Okay, 살아요. I live. 사세요? 사세요? Do you live with a respectful way? 어디 사세요?
어디 사세요?
Okay, 어디 사세요 is more respectful than 어디 살아요? So if you see a person, he looks older than you, and you can ask 어디 사세요? Where do you live? Okay, now let us go. 얼마예요?
얼마예요?
Okay, 얼마 means how much. 이에요. It is or is it, but you can shorten it as 예요. So 예요 is the short way to say 이에요. Okay, so 예요 and 이에요 means is it or it is. So 얼마예요? How much is it? So 예요 becomes question. So you put the ending of 100원이에요.
100원이에요.
It is 101, so you put the ending down. 이거, this, okay. 이거 얼마예요?
이거 얼마예요?
How much is this? 저거, 저거 means that, okay. 그거,
그거.
그거 means it or that in a further way. 이 저그, 이 means this, 저 is that, 그 is it. Okay? So 이거 저거 그거,
이거 저거 그거.
this thing, that thing, and it or that thing. 이거 얼마예요?
이거 얼마예요?
How much is this? 100원이에요. 101. It is 101. Okay. 저거 얼마예요?
저거 얼마예요?
How much is that? 1,000원이에요.
1,000원이에요.
How much is 1,000원? 1,000. 1,000원. Okay. 그거 얼마예요? Okay. How much is it?
얼마예요?
오케이, 10,000원이에요. 오케이, how much is 10,000원? 10,000원. 오케이, 10만 원이에요. 100,000원. 100만 원이에요. 1,000,000원. 1,000만 원이에요. 10 million won. 오, 너무 비싸요. Okay. Can we will go about the salary, 급여, in a second one. Okay. So, but we still have time. Let me try to put. Okay. We will put 급여가 얼마예요? Okay, let's check. 급여가 얼마예요? Okay, let's try to put this slide. Maybe this will be the last lesson for the first class, and we will have second one after 1 hour. Okay. It's taking time. Can you say 급여?
여기요.
오케이. Okay. 이 캔다. 급여, 세 급여가 얼마예요?
급여가 얼마예요?
오케이. Okay. How much is your salary? 오케이. Okay. 급여 is payroll. Now we can say payroll in a different way. 월급.
월급.
월 is monthly, okay, monthly. 급 is pay. So 월급 is monthly pay. So 월급 is monthly salary. Okay, 주급. 주 is a week and 급 is pay. So 주급 is weekly payroll. Okay, 일당.
일당.
Okay, 일 is a day. 당 is a pay. 일당 is daily pay. 연봉.
연봉.
그 연봉. Okay, 연 is year. 봉 is also pay. 연봉 is yearly salary. 시급.
시급.
Okay, 시 is hour. 급 is pay. Hourly wage. Okay. So are you receiving monthly salary or weekly or every 15 days or yearly? Or daily or hourly. Okay, so it depends on your situation. In Korea, if you have the contract with the major companies, usually it is yearly salary. So 연봉. So they do not say the monthly salary. They say how much you will receive per year. Okay, how much will be your salary for 1 year? And they will say bonus will be 700% if it is like that. So if your salary is, for example, $30,000 for 1 year, they will count 700 times for your bonus, which will be divided every year during the holidays. Okay, that's how they do for the major companies like Samsung or Hyundai, LG, or the bank. But smaller companies give not 연봉, they give monthly salaries. Okay, so how much is my pay? For 1 month, that is 월급. Okay, 월급. Now, if you are working in a construction, usually those laborers receive daily wage, so that is called 일당 in the construction company. Now, if you are a student and you are still studying and you are not qualified to work as college graduate or some other qualification, they pay you by hour. So we call like working in a convenience store or coffee shop. So they are paid 시급. So they say how much is your hourly wage? And we have minimum wage, which is called 최저임금, and which is I think 8,731 per hour. That's the I think that's by the law. Can you say 많아요? Okay, 많아요 means much. So you receive a big salary, you say, "Oh, 많아요." It's about 적어요.
적어요.
오케이, little. Now, in your culture, if the husband receives the salary, does he give straight to the wife? No. Okay, so it. Okay, anyway, so it depends on the person. Okay, say,
Hey.
Can you say, 아주? 아주 means very. 아주 많아요.
아주 많아요.
Okay, very much. So your salary is a lot. Okay, we can say also 커요, which is big. 아주 적어요.
아주
It's little. 정말 많아요. 정말
많아요.
means really. It's really a lot. 정말 적어요.
정말
It's
적어요.
really little. 조금 많아요?
조금만
Okay,
적어요.
you are humble, so you say, "Oh, my pay is a bit, not much, but just a bit. 조금 적어요."
적어요.
Okay, so this is about 급여가 얼마예요? How much is your salary? Now we go back there. 이거 얼마예요?
이거
So now, as we end our first class today, I want to say that let us do our best. Let's not be so much concerned about how much we make. Good time will come, okay? If we are faithful and if we do our best. And also, what is important is you must enjoy your work, okay? Okay, my daughter was English teacher in Korea 6 years ago. And she made good money, but teaching is very hard. Today, she runs the company, and then she runs the music store, okay, because she loves that. So, you know, what is important is that you enjoy what you are doing. Okay, salary is important, but do you love what you are doing? So that is it. Anyway, so let's say.
Name in your profile picture is your granddaughter.
Ah, yeah, that is the first granddaughter.